Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me a choice between two things. And he listened. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Allah gave me a choice between, Allah gave me the mafatih al-ghayb, or the mafatih al-dunya, the keys to the dunya, wal-khuld, in eternity. And he gave me the Jannah and him. Capital H, Allah. And then the servant said, Ya Rasulullah, take the mafatih al-dunya and the khuld. We have you with us forever. And you have the entire dunya. We can flourish. In other words, as Muslimin. فَخَيَّرْتُ And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا. أختار الله. I chose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Jannah. The dunya in comparison to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's no comparison to Allah. This is now the day and the moment Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is bidding farewell to the companions. What happened that very day? Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu is in the mihrab, Salatul Fajr. لم يفجأهم إلا رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وقد كشف ستر الحجرة حجرة عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها فنظر إليهم وهم صفوف في الصلاة. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم opened the curtain slightly of the حجرة of سيدة عائشة. And we all know where that حجرة is. If you look out, you can see the روضة الجنة. You can see the روضة. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم turned the cloth of the sitara, and he looked at them, and he looked at the rows of the Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim. SubhanAllah, there is Bilal who was punished in Makkah, standing. There is Umar who came to kill me. There is so and so. And now they are all standing connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After they were at enmity with me, they are standing connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they're engrossed in their salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains its scenery and paints a vivid image in our minds. And that is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, they stand like grown up stalks, beautiful, ready to be harvested. Beautiful, they're grown up, straight up. The farmers walk by, now they have envy for what Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has planted. No? And that envy was there in the hearts of the munafiqun and those who came to cut and mow down those solid, strong believers, spreading fitna between them after the demise of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam opens the sitara fatabassama, and he gave a smile that was indescribable. فَنَقَصَ أَبُو بَكْرَ عَلَىٰ أَقِبَيْهِ لِيَصِلَ الصَّفِ And Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the corner of his eye could see Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he wanted to step back to join in with the saf behind him, so Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can come and lead. This is how beautiful that smile was. It gave them the understanding Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is healthy, he's back on his feet. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, stay. Stay. And this is when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went back into the house. He laid down. وَظَنَّ أَنَّ رَسُولَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَخْرُجَ إِلَى صَلَاتِ فَقَالَ أَنَسْ وَهَمَّ الْمُسْلِمُونَ أَنْ يَفْتَتِنُوا فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ فَرَحًا بِرَسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The Muslimun who saw Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the corners of their eyes, well, to see somebody doesn't break your salah, does it? Doesn't. You know, they saw Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and it almost caused fitna because they became so excited and happy when they saw Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving them that confident smile that it almost caused a fitna for them, in other words, for them to break off their namaz. فَأَشَارَ إِلَيْهِمْ رَسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ pointed to all of them أَنْ أَتِمُّوا صَلَاتَكُمْ continue your salah وَدَخَلَ الْحُجْرَى وَأَرْخَى السِّتْرَى وَمَاتَ مِنْ يَوْمِهِ رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم went in وَأَرْخَى السِّتْرَى and he closed the sitra ومات من يومه and that's the day that رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away. وفيهما أن رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كانت عنده ركوة فيهما فجعل يدخل يده فيه ويمسح بها وجهه ويقول. What happened when رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم goes to sitara? He went and laid on the bed. Sayyidina Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was too weak and too in pain to cool him down with the water. And Sayyida Aisha used to do ruqya with Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that moment. And she, the ruqya was the mu'awwadatan, falaq in nas. And she would read that and she would blow on the hands of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then she would take the hands of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and wipe the hands of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on him to relieve him of pain. And she would take water and put it in the hands of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and wipe on his face, because there's more barakah in the hands of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than her hands. Look at the respect and the understanding of the barakah of Rasul. And as Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was laying, he saw Abdurrahman ibn Abu Bakr coming in and had a miswak in his hand. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his moment is now minutes away from Sakaratul Maut. Now, he saw Abdurrahman ibn Abu Bakr coming in with a miswak and his eyes is following Abdurrahman ibn Abu Bakr. And Sayyida Aisha knew that he wants a miswak, because she knew of his habits. His habits was constant miswak. He used to constantly brush his teeth when he came into the house, when he woke up from the sleep, for every wudu, for every namaz. And she took it, she asked Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you want the miswak? And he said yes. He nodded. She took it and she bit it for him. She cleaned it. In other words, it's a brother's miswak. Abdurrahman ibn Abu Bakr is a brother, and she bit it and cleaned it for him. And from her mouth, his wife, Ummul Mu'mineen, and she passed it on to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fastaka, and he made a siwak, a brush that was one of the most beautiful brushes of his teeth and cleaning of his teeth that I've ever seen, Sayyida Aisha says. And it was after that when the angel of death came and asked him, Ya Muhammad, Allah asks you, do you want the mafatih al-dunya in khuld, or do you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Jannah? And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, inna lil mawti lassakarat, thumma nusiba yadahu. And then he pointed his finger upward, faja'ala yaqul, and he started saying, fi rafiqil a'la, I want the heavenly abode. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away.